Gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you so much for your magnificent grace, mercy, and unconditional love for us. Father, we thank you that you give us resources in which to give back to you so that your kingdom might be expanded and ministries might be able to be implemented and ministered and so that people might come to the saving knowledge of you through your gospel. So God, we ask that you would please multiply these gifts so that that would be a reality to the ends of the earth. In Jesus' name we pray. Brothers and sisters, come to a really neat time in our worship time. Everything is a neat time in our worship time, you know. But this is a real special time. It's a time of prayer. And, you know, the Bible says the prayer of a righteous person availeth much. And boy, I'm seeing living testimony to that. I'm going to embarrass this person, and it's okay, because I know him, and you know his name. But we've been praying for this person for a few weeks now. This person's in our presence this morning. Jack Martin. What a blessing. Power of prayer. Now he's got a road to hoe a little bit, I guess, suspect. But God is doing a work in his life. A tremendous work. He's not done with Jack yet. Pretty exciting. Power of prayer is phenomenal. But I'm also very acutely aware that there are some of you still on journeys. And you need that relief too. And Jesus knows it. And he's in the process of delivering it to you. I just don't know when or how. But I do know he's going to deliver it to you. Because he's faithful. Okay? So, I want us to pray a prayer of response in time. And when I say, Lord, in your mercy, I would ask that you just simply say, hear our prayer. But I would like, if you feel comfortable, to take some requests from you. I'm going to pray a prayer of praise for the presence of our brother Jack being with us this morning. So I'm going to do that for sure. But if there's any others that are on your mind, boy, please feel free to audibilize them if you feel comfortable.
Pastor Betty and Gene Nichols.
How's that again?
Betty and Gene Nichols.
Bill Lawrence.
Yes.
Our granddaughter was having tonsillectomy on Friday.
Okay.
For all the farmers of the Midwest.
What? Nina. Come on, lift up Jack. Thank you for audibilizing these. I understand there are those that maybe not audibilized, but nonetheless, God knows, very important, and he hears. He's going to answer. All right? So I'm going to first pray for these, and then I'm going to go into a different type of a prayer, of a response, and we hear if you say, Lord, in your mercy, if you respond, hear our prayer. God of grace, God of mercy, we love you, Daddy. We really do. What a privilege it is to call you that. Because, God, we just rejoice in how Daddies give us good things. Would you do that? Father, we rejoice in our brother Jack Martin being physically present with us this morning. God. What a tremendous power and testimony to prayer. Oh, my goodness. We are so thankful. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Jesus. God, I ask that you would continue to do a mighty work in his life. I pray that you would continue to heal him. Please allow the pain to go away. Give him the relief that he needs. But then, Father, through this process, I know you're doing another work too. And I pray that you continue to lead him in how you desire. What a blessing he is to this parish and to the church at large. It's a blessing. Father, there's a number of our people that are really hurting. They really, really are, God. And you know it better than anybody. And so I want to lift them up to you, Father, so that you might be able to minister to them in the manner in which you deem is appropriate and very effective. God, this morning we want to lift up Betty and Gene Nichols. We want to lift up Bill Lawrence. We want to lift up a granddaughter having tonsillectomy. We want to lift up our farmers in the Midwest. We want to lift Jack Meadows. We want to lift up Cassie and Al Edwards and Roy. And then, Father, there's a host of others whose requests are so pertinent and so intense that maybe we just can't audibilize them, but you are very much aware of them. God, please reach down and provide your grace, your mercy, your healing, your strength, your encouragement, everything that is needed in order to bring the healing that you deem is appropriate in the time frame that you also deem is appropriate. Father, we give you thanks, glory, and praise. God, you are so good, you are so gracious, and we give you thanks and blessings for the love that sustains us from day to day. We praise you for the gift of your Son, our Savior, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins, and justification. We thank you this day for the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, for your holy church, for the means of grace, for the lives of all faithful and just people, and for the hope of the life to come. God, help us to treasure in our hearts all that you've done for us and enable us to show our thankfulness in lives that are wholly given to your service. Lord, in your mercy, God, we ask that you would please save and defend your whole church that has been purchased with the precious blood of Christ. Strengthen your faithful people through the word and the holy sacraments, making them perfect in love and in all good works, and establishing in them the faith once delivered to the saints. Lord, in your mercy, grant your wisdom and heavenly grace to all pastors and to those who hold office in your church, that by their devoted service, faith may abound and your kingdom increase. Lord, in your mercy, send the light of your truth into all the earth. Raise up faithful servants of Christ to advance the gospel, both in home and in distant lands. Lord, in your mercy, and Father, we ask that in your mercy you would strengthen all congregations and support them in the challenging times that are before them. Make them steadfast, abounding in the work of the Lord, and let their faith and zeal for the gospel refresh and renew the witness of your people everywhere. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, our nation needs your intervention in justice and honor. God, preserve our nation, that we may lead a peaceable life with integrity. Grant health and favor to all who bear office in our land, especially the President, President Trump, and the Congress of the United States, the governor and the legislature of this state, and all of those who make and administer and judge our laws. Help them, Father, to serve this people according to your holy will. Lord, in your mercy, God, please, take from us all hatred and prejudice. Give us the spirit of love and order our days in your peace. Prosper the labor of those who work to bring peace and justice to the nations of the world, that mutual understanding and common endeavor may be increased among all peoples. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Father, by your word and your Holy Spirit, I ask that you would please comfort all who are in sorrow or in need, sickness or in adversity. Be with those who suffer persecution for the faith, and have mercy on those whom death draws near. Bring consolation to those in sorrow, and grant to all a measure of your love, taking it into your tender care. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
So, Heavenly Father, for these requests that we've made, and those that are still upon our hearts, we do commend those to you, ask that you have your way and will in each and every one. And we will give you the thanks, the glory, and the honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.